Hi, it's Dr. Laura Jaggett, and I'm guessing you're here because you've managed to wash your clothes, but now you want to know how to use a dryer. The dryer is a really convenient part of the whole laundry process. So let me show you these few easy steps so that you can get going and have this whole laundry thing covered. Now, the very first thing you want to do is clean your lint trap. The lint trap is this little section right here on the top of my dryer. There are many dryers where you will find the lint trap inside the barrel, usually sitting here. You just pull it out. Sometimes it's on the side, but you're going to open that up first. This is the most important step of using a dryer. Why? Because if the lint builds up, it can start a fire. Yep, people actually use this stuff as tinder, a fire starter. So imagine this whole trap being filled with lint plus heat, that equals dryer fire. So clean the lint trap. Take your wet clothes and put them inside the dryer. Make sure that they're not sopping wet. There are so many different types of dryers with different settings and options, but they're all going to have these basic settings. High heat, which is your timed dry and auto dry. Low heat, which are delicates. And no heat, which is air dry. But most things can be dried on the normal setting, which is high heat. This is an auto setting. Your dryer will sense when the clothes are dry and shut off automatically. And the new dryers these days are pretty accurate. The pros of using this setting is that it uses less energy. If it only takes 10 minutes to dry, it'll shut off automatically. You can also use the timed setting. On this machine, 40 minutes will usually dry everything I put in it, including towels and jeans. You'll have to play around with it and see what works best for you if you choose to use the timed setting. Many machines also have a signal or alarm that indicates when the dryer is done. This machine does not have a signal option. It will buzz automatically on the auto setting, but not on the time setting. If you're lucky enough to have a machine where you can switch that on or off, it's up to you if you want to hear it or not. If you want to use dryer sheets, you can. It's completely optional. They do sort of coat your clothing so that static electricity is reduced, and they can smell nice, and your clothes will be less staticky. But you definitely do not need to use them to run the dryer. Once your clothes are in the dryer and you've selected your settings, throw in your dryer sheet if you're using one, double check that you've cleaned out your lint trap, and then press the start button. And that's it. And here's a pro tip. If you take your clothes out of the dryer as soon as they're done, they will usually be less wrinkled. Hang them up, fold them neatly, and put them away, and then they'll be nice and fresh when you're ready to wear them. If not, at least they'll be clean. That was just a basic tutorial to help you get started. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you'd like to watch the How to Do a Laundry Mominar, click on this video right here. And above all, please subscribe to this channel for more weekly mominars on how to do basic life skills. I'll see you next time.